Welcome to Fix It Home Improvement, covering projects that every homeowner should know and great products for home and garden.
Hi, I'm JC, and this is where we share weekly home improvement tips. I'm here with my co-host, Cindy.
Hello, JC.
Hi, Cindy. This week, we're going to be talking about air purifiers, and we want to thank Justin for giving us a 5-star rating and review for our 10th home improvement ebook, and his title was, wow, book 10. It's called Home Improvement Solutions, What Every Homeowner Should Know, book 10, and you can download a copy on Amazon. And for those of you who have downloaded a copy, we would really appreciate a rating and review. It helps us with Amazon promoting the book. HEPA air filters were developed in the 1940s to filter radioactive particles out of the air during research for the first nuclear weapons. And the filters were kept secret until after World War II. It's interesting, huh? Particles 0.3 microns in size was determined in the 1940s as the most dangerous to breathe in because it penetrates so deeply into your lungs. And that's the standard that stuck for HEPA. The EPA says air quality in our homes can affect our health, and breathing in dust and smoke particles can get deep into our lungs, and long-term exposure to high levels of particles can cause illnesses like bronchitis. VOCs, volatile organic compounds, are chemicals emitted as a gas from products and building materials in our homes. Long-term exposure can cause ear, nose, and throat irritation, headaches, and nausea, and can damage your liver, kidneys, and your central nervous system, and some VOCs can cause cancer.
Really?
The EPA says indoor air quality can be 2 to 5 times worse than outside air in most homes. The CDC says mold is more common in homes than people think. And homeowners should be controlling humidity levels and the temperature to reduce mold.
What temperature and humidity?
So keep your house under 70 degrees and a humidity of 30 to 50% because mold loves high temperature and high humidity. The U.S. Department of Health says indoor mold and mildew produce toxins that can be absorbed into your lungs. And some of the long-term effects of exposure to mold include cancer, neurotoxicity, memory loss, and heart damage. The CDC says not everyone's going to have a sensitivity to mold and mildew, but just because you don't have symptoms of a stuffy nose, a sore throat, or a cough, it can still be damaging to your health. Exposure to mold spores over a long period can cause an allergy to mold, and there's been studies that link exposure to mold as a child increasing the risk of developing asthma.
Interesting.
Yeah. The EPA and the CDC recommend controlling humidity levels in your home by using dehumidifiers or humidifiers and keeping it in that 30 to 50% range. Use a range hood vent when you're cooking to reduce humidity, smoke, and food particles in the air. And use a bath exhaust fan when you're taking a shower or a bath, and then let it run for 20 minutes after you're done.
Right.
Open windows and doors whenever possible to help ventilate the buildup of pollutants in good weather. And if your home has a forced air system, upgrade your furnace and air conditioning filters to a pleated filter rated for your furnace. And that's going to help trap and remove particles in the air. So you want to look at the MERV rating, M-E-R-V.
What is that?
That's the minimum efficiency reporting value.
Okay.
I read an article on the ASHRAE website.
What is that?
It's the American Society of Heating, Refrigerating, and Air Conditioning Engineers. I didn't know refrigerating was a word. So they said recent research shows fine particles in the air in our homes are more hazardous to our health than originally thought. And homeowners should be using a higher efficiency filter if they have forced air systems. They're recommending a MERV 13, but don't go over the recommended MERV rating for your furnace. A filter that's too restrictive can cause high efficiency furnaces to shut down, or it can reduce its efficiency. And I saw a couple other articles recommending a minimum of a MERV 10 for better air quality.
Okay.
The EPA is also suggesting to add portable air cleaners to the most used areas of your home to improve indoor air quality. The main types of air purifiers are a true HEPA, a HEPA type, carbon, electrostatic or ionizer, UV, and ozone. And the most popular are going to be a HEPA or a HEPA type. A true HEPA filter must filter out at least 99.97% of air particles that are 0.3 microns or larger and prevent them from being released back into the air. So HEPA filters are going to remove pollen, dust mites, pet allergens, dander, bacteria, and smoke particles. And out of 10,000 particles hitting the filter, only 3 would escape the first time through. Crazy, huh? There's a company called IQ Air. It's the letter I, the letter Q, and then capital A-I-R. They have hyper HEPA filters. They remove 99.5% of particles 0.003 microns and larger, and that's 10 times smaller than most viruses. And they introduced one of the first air filters for homes in 1963 because one of the owners suffered from asthma.
Huh. The filters will have to be replaced, though.
Right. Yes, they fill up with particles. So check the replacement routine for your air purifier and check the cost between different models when you're shopping.
Mm-hmm.
Also, the HEPA air filters with a pre-filter, they're going to trap large particles before it gets to the HEPA filter, so it's going to add life to the HEPA filter, which is more expensive. Some of these pre-filters can be removed and washed and reused, so that's another thing to compare.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have allergies, a true HEPA filter is going to remove allergens and fine particles that can irritate your allergies. But if you're not bothered with allergies, an air purifier with a HEPA type filter may be less expensive to operate.
Okay.
When you're looking at the label for an air purifier, HEPA type, or it might say HEPA style or HEPA like, they're not meeting the standard for a true HEPA filter. So they're not going to filter out as much or filter out the very small particles. So check the label for what it does well. Some work well for dust or pet dander. And some will list the percentage of particles that will remove from the air, like 85%. HEPA filters are the best for particles in the air, but they're not removing odors and gas. For many VOCs and odors, an air purifier that uses a carbon filter will trap VOCs, gases, tobacco smoke and odor, pet odors, odors from food and cooking. And if you get an air purifier with a HEPA filter and a carbon filter, it's going to clean the air better than just one of those types of filters. Electrostatic or ion air purifiers generally use negatively charged ions to attach to particles in the air, and some air purifiers will trap the particles on a collection rod inside the unit, or the particles will pass through the unit, picking up an extra electron so they become electrically charged. And they're attracted to particles in the air without the extra electron. So the particles stick together in the air. They become too heavy to stay in the air, and they drop to the ground, or they stick to walls and other objects.
Fun.
Some of the ion air purifiers can generate ozone, and that can potentially build up to an unhealthy level in your home. So check the label that it doesn't produce ozone, or it meets the EPA standard. The EPA is warning that even low amounts of ozone can cause chest pain, coughing, shortness of breath, and throat irritation, and ozone may worsen chronic respiratory diseases like asthma and compromise the body's ability to fight infection. And some studies show that ozone can react with chemicals in the air to form byproducts that are potentially dangerous. So the EPA isn't recommending ozone for air purification, and California restricts the sale of ozone-producing air purifiers.
Interesting.
UV air purifiers will kill airborne viruses and bacteria, and many have an easy-to-replace UV light. And UV air purifiers work really well with HEPA filters. So if you have a system where it has both, it's going to remove particles in the air and kill germs.
Okay.
When you're shopping for an air purifier, one of the terms you're going to see and should be comparing is CADR. This is the Clean Air Delivery Rate. And this measures a filter's efficiency in 3 measurements, And this is assigned by the Association of Home Appliance Manufacturers. So you might see AHAM. And they rate how the air purifier will remove smoke, pollen, and dust. The AHAM rating on the CADR label may,
that was a lot of letters.
May have something like tobacco smoke 110, dust 120, pollen 130. The smoke range is from 10 to 450, the dust range 10 to 400, and the pollen range is 25 to 450. So it's easy to compare units side by side and also compare what's important for you in your home.
Right.
And the higher the number, the better it does its job.
Okay.
On some labels, you're only going to see one number, which is an average of the three numbers. And the EPA recommends if there's only one CADR number for a 100-square-foot room, you should look for 65 minimum. 200-square-foot room, 130 CADR. A 300-square-foot room, 195. 400-square-foot, 260. 500-square-feet, 325. And 600-square-feet, 390. A lot of the packaging will tell you what it's rated for in square feet, so that's length times width in a room, and you're usually basing that on an 8 or a 9-foot ceiling. So if you have a bedroom that's 11 feet by 12 feet, 11 times 12 is 132 square feet, and you should be matching up a unit that will work with that size or larger, and that way it's going to do the best job. If the unit has cubic feet on the packaging, cubic feet is length times width times height. So this is good if you have an area with like a vaulted ceiling. So you would multiply, let's say you have a 10 foot by 12 foot room, you'd multiply 10 by 12, which is 120 square feet. And let's say you have a 10 foot ceiling, it would be 1,200 cubic feet. If you see ACH, this is air exchanges an hour, and this is rating how many times the air purifier will pull air through the unit for a specific sized room. A unit that's rated for 500 square feet with a rating of 5 times will exchange the air 5 times an hour, and the higher or the more times it exchanges an hour, the more effective it's going to be.
Interesting.
ARB or CARB on the label means it's certified by the California Air Resources Board that, it meets their electrical standards and ozone emissions, because all portable indoor air purifiers sold in California have to be certified. You should compare the decibels for the sound level, and you'll see a small case D, a capital B, and the higher the number, the louder the unit is going to be. And I would also compare the warranties when I'm looking at different air purifiers.
Okay.
I spoke to Rabbit Air. It's R-A-B-B-I-T, capital A-I-R, and they make top-rated air purifiers. Some of their units have 6-stage filter systems. They just have a bunch of filters. They have true HEPA and carbon filters. So they recommend an air purifier with a HEPA filter and a carbon filter to help control allergies, remove household odors, and VOCs. And they say if you have a smoker in your home or an area that produces odor like a pet bed or a litter box, they suggest placing the unit there to trap as many odors as possible before it spreads throughout your home. And they also suggest keeping an air purifier off the ground. They say it's going to be more effective.
Interesting.
Keep your air purifier away from humidifiers and away from the bathroom, because moisture trapped in the filters will shorten the filter's life. Air purifiers need airflow, so they're saying don't block the intake or the exhaust areas of the unit. Give it a couple feet of clearance and move a portable air purifier throughout the day. So you can keep it in a living room or an area you spend the most time in, and then move it to your bedroom about an hour before you go to sleep. And that's going to improve the air quality. Some are fairly small. Some might be the size of 2.5 Kleenex boxes connected together. Yeah, they come in quite a few sizes. In fact, they have air purifiers that you can mount on a wall. And they have customizable panels. So they have artwork that's on this. So you can hang it on the wall almost like a picture. They have artwork for adults that, you know, maybe like Picasso. And then they have artwork for a kid's room, so you can have like Snoopy on your air purifier. One of their air purifiers is a smart unit, so you can operate it and monitor it with your phone.
Mm.
Wow, huh? I read an article from the Harvard Medical School to improve indoor air quality for someone with allergies.
Mm-hmm.
They're recommending that you vacuum at least once a week with a vacuum with a HEPA filter. Clean all the bedding, drapes, and furniture regularly, and wash your bedding at 130 degrees Fahrenheit or higher to kill dust mites, and use dust mite covers on pillows, mattresses, and box springs. They say plants can improve air quality, but some plants can trigger an allergic reaction or encourage the growth of mold if it raises the humidity level in a room. So they're suggesting use a dehumidifier if you have plants. And if you have a forced air heating system, use filters that remove allergens from the air and also use an air purifier.
Right.
The Asthma and Allergy Foundation estimates 3 in 10 people with allergies will have an allergic reaction to dogs and cats.
Hmm.
So people with moderate sensitivity may get a stuffy nose or inflamed eyes. If you're highly sensitive, it can cause you to cough, to wheeze, to have shortness of breath. You can get a rash on your face.
Huh?
So they're recommending to improve the air quality in your home if you have allergies, to keep pets out of your bedroom. You don't want pets on your carpet or furniture because they leave behind dander and other allergens. So pet dander is microscopic pieces of skin from your dog or cat. And the allergens from dogs and cats are the proteins that are found in dried saliva, urine, and feces.
Yuck.
So this flakes off your pet's fur.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what causes an allergic reaction in some people.
Mm-hmm.
So they're saying keep your door closed for your bedroom. Use a HEPA air purifier in your bedroom. Wear a dust mask when you vacuum. And when you're vacuuming, use a certified asthma and allergy-friendly filter. And certified means it's been tested and it meets very strict standards. And put an allergy and asthma-friendly filter in your furnace if you have a forced air system.
Okay.
Some top-rated air purifiers come from Rabbit Air, IQ Air, Aerocide, so it's A-I-R-O-C-I-D-E, Holmes, H-O-L-M-E-S, Honeywell, Blue Air, Dyson, D-Y-S-O-N, Hunter, and Conway.
Okay. Do you have anything else to add?
The EPA says one of the most important things with a portable air purifier is to make sure it's sized to the area you're going to be using it in, or use multiple air purifiers.
Huh.
Look for a true HEPA filter for the best air quality, and if you get a model with a carbon filter, it'll also help remove odors and VOCs.
Hmm. Let's wrap this up.
You can subscribe to our podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, CastBox, Himalaya, or your favorite podcast app.
If you enjoyed it, please leave us a review.
You can check out our home improvement videos on our YouTube channel, Fix It Home Improvement.
And you can subscribe to that as well.
You can download our ebooks, Home Improvement Solutions, What Every Homeowner Should Know, books 1 through 10 on Amazon.
If you enjoyed it, please leave us a 5-star rating and review.
You can email us at fixitpodcast@gmail.com. You can follow Cindy on Twitter at fixitcohost. And you can follow us on Instagram, fixithomeimprovement.
Thank you for listening.
Talk to you next week. Do